AFTV, we've got Matty here from the Magpie channel. Matty, Newcastle, I don't know, they battled in there tonight, but no real chances from Newcastle today.
Just travelled 300 miles, mate, so you one shot on target. On a Monday night. Do you mean it's 11 o'clock at night now, mate? What's going on? You just came back from Dubai. Did you see any Newcastle players out there? Jesus Christ, I think they're already on holiday. We're 7 points clear of the relegation zone, but they're going on like we're stayed up already. They're just, season's finished for us by the looks of it. The players are just already on the beach, already think they're safe. We're still, I mean, one more win will probably do it. Mm. But come on, man, you kind of travelled here all the way here on a Monday night and put an performance out.
I mean, it was a bit negative, wasn't it? I always thought that, you know, Newcastle were going to come and make it really, really difficult. You've been doing that a lot this season, but I was expecting more of an attacking threat through, you know, recent games I've seen with like Rondon, Ayoza Perez, you got Almer on there, but everybody just seems to be in a defensive shape the whole game.
Yeah, I mean, that's what it is. We've been scoring a few goals late. Obviously, you came back 2-0 down against Everton, yep. 3-2 win. Rondon, Almiron and Prez have been brilliant. Three amigos up top, but where were they the day? Rondon turned into Shola Amiobi. Almiron was trying his best, but he was running into brick walls. Perez, may as well not even been here. He may as well stayed in Newcastle. Didn't do absolutely anything. And just like the rest, lads, I mean, not one of them there can hold their hands up high. Not many of them came over and clapped off the pitch either, which shows they knew they were disappointed in that performance tonight. They didn't turn up. We've been on good run of form lately. The break hasn't probably helped. And like you say, they just haven't turned up at all there. They're already thinking feet on the beach, think they're safe. It's just too early to be going on.
You're safe though, innit? You ain't going down this season.
7 points clear. 7 points clear, probably. We've got some big games coming up at home. Palace, Brighton, Southampton. So we should stay up, no doubt about that. But they've still got to put on a performance tonight, you know what I mean? Coming all the way down here on a Monday night. They've still got to put a shift in. And we didn't expect anything. I said we'd get beaten tonight, but it's how you get beaten it. You've got to put in a performance. You've got to put in a shift for the travelling fans. And like I say, one shot on target, mate. It's absolutely pathetic.
And what did you make at Arsenal?
You didn't have to get out of second gear, did you? Absolutely cruised that. You didn't have to do anything. Two good goals. Good finish by Ramsey for the first one. Yedlin was poor. Got caught out. Sloppy again out of position. Lacazette, really good finish. Chipped Dubravka. But again, Lascelles are slow. It's very slow to it. But yeah, I mean, I don't know. I think you didn't really have to try. And that says a lot as well. You know me, mate. I rate Arsenal as a good team, especially for where he is on now, third in the league. Very good. You're always going to do that over the Spurs bottle jobs, aren't you? You'll always get out up to fade, no, blah, 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 blah. But I think he'll do well. I think Emery's looking like a good manager. A couple of signs in the summer, and he's going to really push for it next year.
And Rafa will stay, you reckon?
Oh, I don't know.
I heard them saying, I heard somebody who's like a Newcastle reporter saying today that he's heard the inside information that Rafa's definitely going to stay. Do you think that'll be a big boost?
Well, we were on Sky Sports the other day, and Keith Downey was saying he thinks Rafa's going to stay. But I won't believe it until it comes out legit. Because, I mean, why would you? Broken promises for Mike Ashley every year. This is a man who's won the Champions League. He just wanted to fight for 17th every year. He wants to be competing with the likes of Arsenal, top six, top eight. That's all we expect. You know, he managed to get a championship side, a 10th place last year. He just wants a bit of ambition, a bit of signings. He finally gave it with Almiron, finally broke Mike Owen's record in January there. So we need a few more players like that just to make sure we're not just scraping relegation every year, because it's not what this club deserves.
And Matty, you know what, finally, before you go, right, just so that people, because a lot of people will watch a game on TV, they'll see this game tonight and they'll see like Arsenal, maybe an Arsenal fan, just explain to them, if you're a Newcastle fan now, going back to Newcastle, what time will a Newcastle fan get home?
4 o'clock if they're lucky. 4 o'clock if they're lucky, yeah. I think the last train was about 11, half 11. The buses will take about 6-7 hours. And just think after that. It's a good job I like the beer, isn't it?
Your end was sold out as usual.
And it's crazy, not on a Monday night. People having to take half days, probably days off work tomorrow. It just shows the dedication. It's a shame we haven't got to own out a match, that ambition. I just want to say something to Robbie, right? You've done more for football, mate, than Harry Kane. You should be knighted instead of him, aye? And Kane should have squared it still at the World Cup. Huh? Seriously.